take. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Oh, it's hard in the field, yeah, we tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
So southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Los Angeles Chargers. Dustin Hopkins set to get this one going. And we are underway in Southern California. This fielded right at the goal line. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line. Here you go, here you go.
The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Now Joe Mixon. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 32-yard line.
Here's Burrow. A throw for Boyd, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Kazir White. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. Not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know the fans are thinking right now, I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school, he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10. Just shy of midfield at the 48.
And this is Cook with a grab. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
From the 45 on second down, Herbert. They'll set up the screen here to Justin Jackson. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. For Charles' first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Right side caught by Jackson. And down inside the 15 he goes.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Herbert operating from the red zone. Touchdown! It's complete. Jared Cook, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
8 yards to go on second down. Now it's Burrow. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzomah. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL, but just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards. I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Looking to throw again on second down. Burrow. And the catch made, it's Tyler Boyd.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. They go back to the ground now with Mixon. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Burrow going to give this to Mixon, and he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one.
Pinball Joseph on the tackle. A gain of a yard brings up third and inches.
Here we go.
6-0 our score after one. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's third and inches. Burrow will throw. Flush to his right. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
Being chased out left. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
And now they will throw it with Burrow. Open man is Uzama. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 13-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Mixon with a first down carry. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stump that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
On second and 11 now, Burrow eluding the pressure right. Now Burrow loses the football. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Now Burrow. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. These guys have been driving down the field, but defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure, that's going to lead to a fourth down. Well played.
Fourth and goal, and down by a touchdown. The offense stays on the field. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. 10 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Bengals draw even, and of course they can take the lead if they hit the extra point. And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. So back even at 6 apiece as the kick's away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Chargers in good field position to start out, first and 10 at the 41-yard line. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. Here's Herbert. Wide open, it's Allen complete.
I'm showing you, man.
Allen hit, he lost the football, and the Bengals grab it. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing that danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
There's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. The 20, and he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. A big play there on the catch and run.
I don't think there's anyone who could possibly doubt how fast he could run on the open field, but if there were, he silenced those thoughts there.
A real field flipper there, as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. From the gun to give to Mixon. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Second and 5 now. Burrow. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
That's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
This offense converted once on 4th down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Jamar Chase. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Bengals have taken the lead.
Zach Taylor's made the decision. They'll go for 2 here. And Burrow's going to look to throw for it.
And that is incomplete. So unable to throw it in for 2 from the 2. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a 2-point conversion as far as how you're defending?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. If they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head, because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
The Charger drive about to get going. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up.
Here's 2nd and 10. Here's a quick throw caught by Allen. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24.
That's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the first down.
Running on first down, Eckler. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Herbert now. He finds his target, Allen. Touchdown, Chargers. And Charles, when you talk about Keenan Allen, you're not necessarily talking about that crazy top-end speed, but he does a great job there with the ball in his hands.
And I caught a quick glimpse of him before the ball was snapped, and there was something about his body language where you could tell early in this play, he wasn't just thinking first down. He was thinking end zone, and he got there.
And the next gen stats show us the tale of how much yardage he was able to tack on after the catch. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This taken in at the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Bengals drive about to get going. And they'll have a little bit of time to work with. 35 seconds until the break. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. Second and 8 coming up. Burrow looking to pass. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted.
Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr.
And the Chargers are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
After the turnover, here's Herbert. Throws left side, complete to Keenan Allen.
Ooh, he's running, he's running.
Touchdown! And the Chargers get the quick strike touchdown. And can you believe it? He misses another one, his third so far. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Bengals drive about to get going. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he's going to lose yardage. Not that it matters as the final seconds tick away. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter.
Well, certainly not what they wanted out of the locker room here, as they'll start defensively at the 40-yard line.
Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10
at the 41-yard line.
They'll hand off here to Eckler.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Now Eckler. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Second and 2.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. Herbert just beat the play clock.
That is caught. It's Williams.
And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the 3rd downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the 3rd quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. He's got his tight end Anderson open right side. And the Chargers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the 1st down.
Herbert, quick pass out wide. Touchdown! Jared Cook, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game.
And the Chargers take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Brandon Staley telling his troops to stay out there and go for two.
They're going to keep it on the ground. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
Brandon Wilson now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
First down, here's Burrow. Escaping the pressure right. That is caught. It's Uzama. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big connection on that one. 36 yards.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Burrow. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do some. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
Now, meanwhile, a final play here is incomplete, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down. And he will find his man Chase complete. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Trey Hendrickson just creating a disaster there for the offense as that one goes 16 yards in the wrong direction. So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise. They're in the dime. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Going deep here for Allen. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They snap it to Herbert. He's got a man. That's Keenan Allen. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line.
I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Beckler, they run left side. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out. We've got them now.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big game that time for the Chargers. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, this game's over.
And the Chargers are going to have a first and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the 2 minute warning. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. Herbert jet sweep as he taps it forward. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. From the 2 now, second and goal.
Brings up second and goal at the 2-yard line.
Trying to punch it in with Eckler. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Austin Eckler taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Chargers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. And oh, he clanks it off the right upright. And it's no good. The missed PAT in his rearview mirror. He goes back out to kick this one off. From his end zone, Wilson. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try to put points on the board.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Let's just be frank.
they're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Chris Harris speeds in for the sack on the corner blitz. So that'll leave Burrow and the Bengals with a third and long after that sack we just saw. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know, in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And a ball going to be intercepted yet again. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Well, I guess an interception at this point on fourth down is just as bad as an incomplete pass. Either way, the ball goes over to the other side.
Yeah, it's a tough spot to be in this late in the game, and there's not a whole lot he could do there. And he winds up giving the ball away.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
It's Eckler again. Well, still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the L.A. Chargers. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.